Raja Datta. He is the head for GS Sanyal School of Telecommunication and also
at IIT
Kharagpur. Welcome, sir. So could you tell us a little bit about GS Sanyal School of Telecommunication?
GS Sanyal School of Telecommunication was conceived in 1996. Mm-hmm. And it is actually, we have a electronics and communication department at IIT Kharagpur, which is one of the oldest department in the on all the IITs. Mm-hmm. You must be knowing that IIT Kharagpur started in 1951, it's the oldest IIT in India. Mm-hmm. GS Sanyal School of Telecommunication is, in fact, it's a school which works in basically in communication area, in all types of telecommunication area. Mm-hmm. So presently we are having several faculty members who mm-hmm. do research work. Mm-hmm. We are having a lot of research scholars mm-hmm. and masters. We also have a master's course on wireless communication and networks.
Okay. So and how old is this school?
This school is 1996. It was conceived in 1996.
And what is the current?
And actually, it is actually been a brainchild of. Mm-hmm. One of the founder of ACL, Mr. Arjun Malhotra.
I see. Okay.
Mr. Arjun Malhotra, he gave us seed money and in fact, he actually, he is a alumnus of IIT Kharagpur.
Okay.
And G.S. Sanyal being one of the legendary teachers mm-hmm. at IIT Kharagpur, he wanted to, and he was also the director, ex-director of IIT Kharagpur.
Okay.
So he wanted to make this particular school in his name.
Wonderful.
Professor G.S. Sanyal School of Telecommunication.
Wonderful. You know, during the day we also heard about, you know, IIT Kharagpur deploying the 5G testbed in their campus.
Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yes. G.S. Sanyal School of Telecommunication is working with 5G for several years now. Mm-hmm. In fact, one or two of our faculty members were involved in waveforming, which mm-hmm. is the basic thing of 5G. Mm-hmm. So that has been done several years back.
Okay.
There are several other faculty members who are mm-hmm. working with 5G. Mm-hmm. We have several test beds already at IIT Kharagpur in this particular school.
Okay.
And these test beds are all working test beds.
I see.
And our research scholars are working on developing this 5G technology.
Okay.
In IIT Kharagpur.
And since how long have you been working on this?
We are, in fact, I was talking about the waveform, etc. It was done way back in 2011 or 12.
Okay.
Yes. And then it was, and then after that, there are several work has been done.
Okay.
In 5G.
I see. Any specific sectors or any specific verticals that you guys are focusing on?
There's nothing called specific. Mm-hmm. In fact, we work on resource allocation.
Okay.
And what's specific, which is very specific to IIT Kharagpur and GS Sanyal School of Telecommunication is the optical domain.
Okay.
Which possibly very few people are working in India.
I see.
So the back hall and the front hall.
Okay.
We'll be actually making a test bed very soon.
Okay.
And we are already, few people are already working on the optical network.
I see.
And the optical back hall.
Okay.
And front hall of 5G.
Okay.
Yeah,
I see. So wonderful. Yeah. So are they also available on any other technologies, existing technologies?
No, optical network is already there.
Okay.
Optical WDM, mm-hmm. wavelength division multiplexing, mm-hmm. Routing and spectrum allocation. These are some of the research work is going on.
Okay.
In fact, I am working on optical WDM for many years now, 25 years now.
Okay.
So, but then the optical backhaul mm-hmm. and the front haul for 5G.
Okay.
So that is getting now worked upon in GS Sanyal School of Telecommunications.
In terms of the IPRs and patents, can you talk a little bit about?
There are several patents actually from IIT Kharagpur.
Okay.
And in fact, the best part is that IIT Kharagpur is possibly the only IIT we have a separate school for intellectual property law. Which is called Rajiv Gandhi School of Intellectual Property Law.
Okay.
So there's a separate department mm-hmm. where the faculty members are lawyers and judges, retired judges and lawyers.
Okay.
They come here and teach, mm-hmm. and we actually try to make aware mm-hmm. the students as well as researchers mm-hmm. about the importance of patent
I see.
For for India.
That's
interesting. So that I think is very unique of IIT Kharagpur.
Okay. So besides the optical, you know, part of it, besides the 5G testbed part of it, are you also, I'm sure, also be working on 5G or this IoT sensor based things?
Yes.
So are these also a part
of it? Working with several organizations. Like I myself work with railways for bridge health monitoring.
Okay.
Because most of the railway bridges are manually been monitored till now.
Okay.
So there we are we are working on automatic monitoring with the help of IoT.
Okay.
Right.
Interesting.
And then there are several other areas where IoTs are being done, like in the drone part is there,
okay.
And then image sensing, etc.
I see.
So those are from different departments.
Okay.
That they are basically working on this IoT.
Okay. Wonderful. Sir, one question on the Digital India mission of the current government. As to, you know, how do you associate yourself with it?
Yes. Actually, let me tell you that for the last 5 years, I am one of the national coordinators along with IIT Bombay's Professor Fatak, Professor D.B. Fatak. So he was from IIT Bombay and I was from IIT Kharagpur.
Okay.
We were a part of a program called Talk to 10,000 Teachers.
Okay. Okay.
So there, IIT Kharagpur, we have, for the last 5 years, we have done several courses and several sessions. And it is it's basically, we target, why it is called Talk to 10,000 Teachers, is in one go, we try to train 10,000 technical teachers, 10,000 technical teachers in India. I think this is one of the, not one, it is the biggest training course being conducted anywhere in the world.
Absolutely.
Right. So it was done online, real time.
Okay.
It is not online, been videoed and then it was
real-time
run.
Basis.
No, it is real time. The teachers are sitting there in my studio there at IIT Kharagpur and there are 350 remote centers across India.
That's wonderful.
Right. And there will be like 30, 40 teachers in each of these remote centers.
Okay.
So you add up, it will come to around 10,000 or so. And the teachers will be teaching, in fact, giving lectures from the studio using NKN.
I see.
National Knowledge Network.
Okay.
Right.
Wonderful.
So, yeah. So we have a software by which, in fact, it is a huge classroom, you can say.
Absolutely. But that too, a virtual one.
It's a virtual classroom. And where the real-time teachings are imparted to the technical teachers. It's basically a training for the technical teachers.
Wonderful.
And for the last 5 years, we have done, and we and IIT Bombay, we had trained, I think, around 150,000 teachers by now.
Amazing.
In various areas, various departments.
That's a wonderful.
Right, from mechanical to electrical to computer science. To civil engineering, and we have actually taken some basic courses from each of the departments.
I see.
Like from electrical, we have taken control systems, from mechanical, fluid mechanics, similarly from computer science, we have taken algorithms.
Okay.
So from each of the departments, we actually, from electronics, like signals and systems.
I see.
So from each department, we used to target a core area, and then we used to take a session.
Okay, wonderful. Great. Our congratulations to you and your team on achieving.
And we got an excellence award, which was been awarded by the minister.
Okay.
I think last year.
I see.
Last year.
Okay.
I am Ahmedabad. I am Ahmedabad or somewhere it was.
I see. So that takes me to the last question of this episode. Can you talk about the industry collaboration part of it, as to how you do you see this ecosystem helping you guys, you know, do what you plan to do?
What I am seeing for the last, because I am into academics from 1990, you can say.
Okay.
So many years now. Earlier it was not that much.
Okay.
But for the last maybe 10 years or 15, 15 years or so, a lot of industries are coming forward now to have a collaboration with academics, which was not so earlier.
Okay.
In fact, in US or in other Western countries, it was there for many, many years now.
True.
But in India, it is gaining momentum. And a lot of private companies are now coming up.
Okay.
They're showing interest, they're investing, they're having labs. We have Samsung Labs at IIT Kharagpur.
Okay.
Similar to what you have heard today that they are having at IIT Delhi.
Right.
So we are also having at IIT Kharagpur.
Mm-hmm.
We have, earlier we had Microsoft Labs.
Okay.
So various now private companies are coming forward. They are setting up labs.
Okay.
We are having, in fact, talk with the Qualcomm also.
Okay.
So there's various companies they are coming forward.
Wonderful.
So this is one, what I understand is a very important aspect for a particular country to develop, particular research to get shape and also to get implemented.
Okay.
Because what was missing earlier was that there was the buffer was missing.
Okay.
The buffer between an, an academic institution and a company, and a company, because companies used to just make the products and sell it. Academics used to do research and publish papers.
Right.
But now I think so both are coming together.
Coming.
And as Mr. Kaushik was today, they were saying that they have made a team which actually acts as the buffer now.
Oh, I see.
Because we are academic institutions, we are not product making companies.
Companies. Correct.
So they have to come forward for that particular part where they will have to take the technology being developed by academic institutions and then implement it. First make prototype, test it and do all types of testing. There are several types of testing and then implement it.
Okay.
So that part now the companies are doing. I think I'm very happy with that.